Hello dear students, as we are doing chapter number 3 and yesterday we have done Kirchhoff's law. Today we are going to understand Kirchhoff's law by its application. Basically we are going to solve some numericals today, and by those numericals we are try to understand Kirchhoff's law in a better way. Okay, so let us solve some numericals. The first numerical is, this is the circuit given, and what we have been told that find the current in each branch. So this is the question. We have to find the current in each branch. How many branches are there? So for finding out the branches, I have told you, just find out the junctions. One junction is here, one junction is here. This is not a junction, this is simply a turn. Similarly, this is not a junction, this is simply a turn. Now let us name the points A, B, C, D. How many loops are there? Basically two. A, B, C, A, A, C, D, A. Okay. So for two loops, we are going to apply loop law. Okay. Then we'll have two equations. So basically what we'll try to do, we'll try to make the variable of current, two variables of current, so that we'll have two equations and then we can solve. From 4 volt, let us assume a current I1 is flowing. And from 5 volt, let us assume a current I2 is flowing. Okay, when these two currents come at this junction, basically they add to each other and they become a current of I1 plus I2. See, for this junction, total incoming current is equal to total outgoing current. Is it like this? Total incoming current is equal to total outgoing current. Moreover, this I1 plus I2, when it reaches over here, then again it will be divided. Now in this branch, this is a single branch, we have already assumed that current is I1. So basically in this branch the current will be I1 and in this branch the current will be I2. Okay. Now according to current and according to cell, we will put plus minus sign. For this cell, this is plus, this is minus. For this resistance, current is entering from this side. So this is plus, this is minus. For this resistance, current is going this way. From this end, the current is entering. So this is plus and this is minus. For this resistance, current is entering from this way. So this is plus and this is minus. For this cell, this is minus, this is plus. Okay. For cell, it is clear. The bigger line represent plus. The other line represent minus. So this is how we have assumed the current and we have divided the current in the circuit. One very important thing in the Kirchhoff's law, actually the division of current is not necessarily as it is given in the book. Okay, it is a solved example, but if you are assuming the current like this, it is not necessary that in the book the same currents has been assumed, the same value of current has been assumed. Okay, the variation in the assumption can take place, but ultimately when we apply the law and solve, we'll get the same answer. Okay, so now let us take the loops and let us try to solve the question. We'll try to take the first loop, this one, ABCA. Let us solve. Solution. We are going to take loop ABCA. This is our path to move. First of all, we'll go from A to B, then B to C, then C to A. Well, let us move A to B. From where to where we are going? First of all, we'll encounter with this cell. This is plus, this is minus. So basically, we are going from positive to negative. Our potential is decreasing. So what we are supposed to write? We are supposed to write minus 4 volt. Okay, V is not required. Ultimately, we are writing volt only. Okay. So this is minus 4. Okay. From plus to minus we are going. That's why it is minus. We are decreasing our potential. then we'll reach to point B. From B to C, when we'll move, we'll encounter with 60 ohm resistance. Here we are moving minus to plus. While going from B to C, our direction will go from minus to plus. So basically the potential increases. And what we are supposed to write, what is the amount of current which is flowing? We are supposed to write plus 60 I1. Current into resistance is equal to what? V is equal to I into R. So this is I, this is R. Basically then they will be multiplying, they will give the potential difference across 60 volt. Why it is written plus? Because we are moving minus to plus. Now we'll reach to the point C. Now C2 way. Again we are moving minus to plus. Again we are moving minus to plus. What we are supposed to write? We are supposed to write plus 20 ohm in bracket I1 plus I2. Because the total current which is flowing, it is I1 plus I2. Is equal to what? 0. Okay? So this is the equation what we get from the first loop. Now just simplify this equation. 60 I1 plus 20 I1, it will be 80 I1 plus 20 I2 is equal to, 4 is transferred to that side, we'll have 4. If we divide the equation by 4, it will be 20 I1 plus 5 I2 is equal to 1. This is your equation number 1. What we get from the first loop. Now let us take the second loop. The second loop is loop ACDA. We are moving in this one. Okay? From A to C, if we go, we'll go from plus to minus. We'll go from plus to minus. So what we are supposed to write? Minus 20 in bracket I1 plus I2. Why minus? Because we are moving plus to minus. Now from C to D, from plus to minus, again we are going from plus to minus. What we are supposed to write? Minus 200 I2. Minus 200 I2. Now again we are moving from minus to plus. This time it is minus to plus. So we are increasing our potential. So we are supposed to write plus 5 volt is equal to 0. All these things are in voltage only. Okay. Now minus 20 I1, minus 20 I2 or minus 200? It will be minus 220 I2 is equal to minus 5. 5 is transferred to that side. Or we'll divide by minus 5 over here. It will become 4I1 plus 5 4s are 20, 5 4s are 20, I2 is equal to 1. This is your equation number 2. Now we'll have two equations. One is 20I1 plus 5I2 is equal to 1, and this is 4I1 plus 44I2 is equal to 1. Okay, now we'll solve these values for I1 and I2 and we'll get what we are required. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to multiply the second equation by 5 so that it will become 20. Okay, so if you multiply it by 5, let us not divide 5 from here, let it be like this, just multiply it with minus sign so that it becomes 20 I1 plus 220 I2 is equal to 5, equation number 2. Now just subtract the equation 1 from 2 or 2 from 1. Equation number 1 minus equation number 2. Equation number 1 is 20 I1 plus 5 I2 is equal to 1. Equation number 2 is 20 I1 plus 220 I2 is equal to 5. Now put minus sign because we are subtracting. 20 I1 will be cancelled out. From 220 I2, 5 I2 subtract, we are going to have minus 215, from 225 is subtracted, 215 will be left, minus 215 I2 is equal to minus 4, minus and minus sign will be cancelled out, so I2 will be equal to what, 4/250 ampere. This is the value of I2. Now if the value of I2 is known, then you can put in any of the equation and can get the value of I1. Okay? And if you get the value of I1, so let's solve it. Now, just let us put in this equation only or in that equation, any of the equation. Let us put it in the equation number 1. We'll have 20 I1 plus 5 I2. So 5 is multiplied with 4/250 is equal to 1. This is the first equation. Now 5 will cut 215. 5 4s are and 5 3s are. 4/43, it will be transferred to that side. So it will become 20 I1 is equal to 1 minus 4/43. Or 20 I1 it will be equal to 39/43. Or I1 is equal to 39/43 multiplied by 2, it is 860 ampere. So value of I1 is 39/860 ampere. So what is the current which is flowing through the branch CBA? It is I1. So I1 is 39/860 ampere. What is the current which is flowing through the branch CDA, direction of current? I2 is what? 4/215 ampere. And what is the current which is flowing through the branch AC? So basically sum of these two. So what we are going to do? We are going to sum of these two and let us see what will be the answer. Okay. So current, in what manner the answer should be there? Answer should be written in this manner. Just see. Current through which branch? CBA. CBA is equal to, we have assumed I1, and value of I1 is 39/860 ampere. Okay, in this manner we are supposed to write the answer. Second part is the current in CDA, we have assumed it I2, and it is equal to 4/250 ampere. Right? And the last one, the current through the branch AC, IAC, it is basically I1 plus I2. So I1 is 39/860, I2 is 4/250. If you take LCM, it will be 860. Now it will be 39. 215 multiplied by 4, it will be this one. 39 plus 16, how much? It will be 55. So 55/860 ampere. Okay, we can solve it also. Okay, so if we solve it, what we are going to have, IAC is equal to how much? Suppose we cut it by 5, so we are going to have 11/5, 3 36, 5 7 35, 1 left, 11/172 ampere. So this is the value of IAC, this is the value of ICDA, and this is the value of the first current. So these three currents will be our answer. Okay, in this manner this Kirchhoff law has been solved. Is it clear? So basically this part, Kirchhoff's law helps you to what? Helps you to make the equation. Thereafter solution will take the knowledge of mathematics. How you are going to solve the equations, now all the things are depend upon that only. Okay, so this is the first question we'll take. We took in this Kirchhoff's law. Now the second question I am going to take is solved NCRT example. One of the very important questions related to Kirchhoff's law, and it will take some space. Okay, so what I am going to do? I am going to remove this chapter introduction. All we know that chapter number 3 is going on. Okay. Just go through your books, whatever books you are having, and solve the questions related to Kirchhoff's law. Okay, one question is there. I will tell you the NCERT number. You have to solve it for your homework. Okay, for your practice. If you are not able to solve, then let me know, we will discuss that. Okay. Now let us take the question which is there in the NCERT, and it is in solved example. Now let us take the second question. As I have told you, it is the solved example of NCERT, and the question is like this. What is the question? This is the circuit given. What is the question? Question is, find current in each branch. This is the question. Find current in each branch. Now we'll try to solve question. Okay? Now first of all, the first thing we need to do is assume the current. As I have told you, okay, the number of loops, first of all we have to see, so it is 1, 2, 3. 3 loops can be seen clearly. So maximum variable we can assume is 3. Okay, so that we can, from 3 loops we are going to have 3 questions. And maximum variable, if it will be 3, then we can solve the equations to get the values of variable. Okay, so let us take the currents. Suppose from 10 volt, the current I1 comes out. Okay, at the junction A towards the B, let the current I2 go, and if from I1 I2 go that side, so what we are going to have at the bottom at this branch, it will be I1 minus I2. Okay, this current will be I1 minus I2. This current is I2, from this current is I1. Now I2 reaches to point B. From this step, let us assume a current I3 comes out. At point B, I2 and I3, they add up together, and the current which flows through this 2 ohm resistance will be I2 plus I3. Okay, out of this current I2 plus I3, at C some current will go towards this side, but in this branch we have already assumed the current is I1. So out of this current I2 plus I3, I1 amount of current flow in this branch CA. The current which is left, what is the amount of current is left? The current which is left is I2 plus I3 minus I1. So this is the current which is left, and now this current will flow from C to D. Okay, from C to D. Now from A to D we are having I1 minus I2. From C to D we are having I2 plus I3 minus I1. So at D, these current will add up, and now the next amount of current will pass from here. So what will be the current? The current is I1 minus I2 from this side, and it will be added with I2 plus I3 minus I1. So I1 and I1 will be cancelled out, I2 and I2 will be cancelled out, we are left with I3 only. So what is the current which goes from D to E? It will be I3 only. Okay, it will be I3 only. There is no any other value of current. And one more thing, since we have assumed that in this branch, which branch? BED, the current is I3. Already we have assumed. So this current must be equal to I3, which is there with the calculation also. It simply indicates that our calculation is okay. Our assumption is okay. Now, in 3 loops, we are going to solve, we are going to apply Kirchhoff's loop law, and then we will make equations and then we will solve it. Okay, let us solve. So first of all, put plus and minus sign. For this cell, this is plus, this is minus. For this resistance, current is entering from this side, so this is plus and this is minus. For this resistance, this is plus, this is minus. For this resistance, this is plus, this is minus. For this resistance, current, the end to from which current is entering, it is plus and it is minus. For this cell, it is plus, it is minus. Okay, now we are going to take loop. Which loop? Loop A, C, B, A. From A to C, if we move, the first thing we encounter with is a cell of 10 volt. We are moving plus to minus, so basically potential decreases. So what we are supposed to write? Minus 10 volt. Okay, minus 10 volt, right? Then this resistance, minus to plus, we are supposed to write plus. What is the resistance? It is 1 ohm. What is the current? It is I1. So I1 multiplied by 1, it will be I1 only. Now from C to B, minus to plus, we will write plus. 2 multiplied by this one, 2I2 plus I3. Okay. Now from B to A, minus to plus, we are supposed to write plus. And the current is what? I2. So it will be 4I2. Current multiplied by resistance, basically I am writing resistance multiplied by current. It will be same. So this is the equation what we get. Now just simplify this equation. What we are going to have? I1, we have only one I1 over here. Let it be I1. 2I2 plus 4I2, it will be 6I2 plus 2I3. Okay, 2I3. Minus 10 is transferred that side. 10. Equation number 1. Okay. So this is the equation number 1 we get from this loop. Now we'll take another loop. Loop. This one. ADCA. ADCA. Now, while moving from A to D, for this resistance, this is plus, this is minus. We are moving plus to minus. We should write minus 4. In bracket, what is the current? I1 minus I2. Plus. Now from D to C, we are moving minus to plus. We should write plus. Already I have written 2 in bracket I2 plus I3 minus I1. Okay. From C to A, minus I1. Because we are moving plus to minus. For this cell, minus to plus we are moving plus 10 is equal to 0. Okay. Now, the C, minus 4I1 from here, minus 2I1 from here, and minus I1 from here. How much where it is going to be? It is going to be 7I1. Okay? Minus 4I1, minus 2I1, and I1. It will become minus 7I1. Now, minus and minus will become plus. 4I2 plus 2I2, 6I2, only 6I2. It will become 6I2. Okay? Now, for I3, we have only one value, plus 2I3 is equal to minus 10. Okay, if you multiply the equation with minus sign, it will become 7I1 plus 6I2 plus 2I3, it will become minus. So we are going to have minus 6I2 minus 2I3 is equal to 10. This will become plus. This will be equation number 2. Okay, now let us take the third loop. The third loop is this one. Okay, we are moving in the same manner anti-clockwise. So we are going to take loop B, C, D, E, B. B, C, D, E, B. Okay, B, C, D, E, B. Now from B to C, if we go from plus to minus, so we are supposed to write minus. Resistance is 2 ohm and the current is I2 plus I3. I2 plus I3. From plus to minus we are moving. We are supposed to write minus. The current is I2 plus I3 minus I1. Now D, E minus to plus, it is plus 5. E to B, nothing is there, is equal to 0. This is how the equation is made. Okay, now just take the similar quantities together. Minus 2 minus I1. It will become 2I1. Minus 2I2 from here, minus 2I2 from here, it will become minus 4I2. Minus 2I3, minus 2I3, it will become minus 4I3. Is equal to minus 5. Okay, So this is equation number 3. Okay. Now the role of physics gets over here, and now only mathematics is left. We have got 3 equations. What you are supposed to do? You are supposed to solve these 3 equations and get the value of I1, I2 and I3. Okay? Get the value of I1, I2 and I3. Okay? Now, let us try to solve these 3 equations. If you can see the first equation and the second equation, if you add first equation and second equation, first equation and second equation, 7i1 plus i1, it will become 8i1. Minus 6i2 plus 6i2 cancelled. Minus 2i3 plus 2i3 cancelled. Is equal to 10 plus 10, 20. From here, i1 is equal to 20 upon 8, which gives us 4 5s are 20, 4 2s are 8. So basically I1 is equal to 5 upon 2 ampere. I1 we have calculated. The value of I1 is 5 upon 2 ampere. Now I am going to solve for I2 and I3. We'll put I1 in the equation number 1. Okay. So from 1, just assume if I put 5 upon 2 over here, so if it go that side, it will become 10 minus 5 upon 2. Okay. So 6i2 plus 2i3 is equal to 10 minus 5 upon 2. It will become 15 upon 2, right? Let this be equation number 4. Now, the same value I am going to put in this equation also. Third, from 3, if I put 5 upon 2, 2 and 2 will be cancelled out, only 5 will be left, 5 will go that side, so it will become minus 5. Minus 5 and minus 5 will become minus 10. So what we are going to have, minus 4i2, minus 4i3 is equal to minus 10. Okay, are you able to understand? Just put the value of I1 over here, it will become 5.2, 2 and 2 will be cancelled out, it will become 5, 5 will go that side, so 5 minus 5, minus 5, it will become minus 10, so here it is minus 10. So this is your equation number 5. Now what you are supposed to do, you are supposed to solve these equations, equation number 4 and equation number 5. Let me write 15 upon 2 straight away over here, 15 upon 2. Okay, straight over here, so that we can solve these two equations and get the value of I1 and I2 and I3. So what we are supposed to do, we are going to multiply, this is your equation number 4, so we are going to multiply the equation number 4 with 2 and then we are supposed to add them, just add the equation. Okay. If 2 is multiplied with 6, it will become 12i2. 12i2 minus 4i2, it will become 8i2. 2 2s are 4i3, minus 4i3, it will be cancelled out. If you multiply it by 2, it will become 15. 15 minus 10, it will become 5. So basically, it is equal to 5. So I2 will be equal to what? I2 will be equal to 5.8 ampere. This is the value of I2. Okay. Now I2 I have calculated, I1 I have calculated. So we are supposed to solve for I3 now. How we can? Just put the value of I2 and I1 in first equation. In equation 1. Okay. In 1. Value of I1 is 5.2 ampere plus value of I2 is 5 upon 8. 6 is multiplied, that is 5 upon 8. Okay? 6, 2s are 12 minus 4. 8, okay, correct. 15 minus 10, 5. You are not subtracting, right? Okay. 6 multiplied by 5 for 8 plus 2i3 is equal to 10. Now, just see, if you solve it, it will become 2, 3 is 6, 2, 4 is 8. It will become 15 upon 4 and it is 5.2. Okay? So 5 upon 2, if we add 15 upon 4, it will become 25 upon 4. Okay, by taking LCM, you can add them. 25 upon 4. Okay? Plus 2i3 is equal to 10. Okay? Is it clear? Now 2i3 is equal to what? 2i3 is equal to 10 minus 25 upon 4. Okay, 10 minus 25 upon 4. 4 tens are 20 minus 25. It will become 15 upon 4. Now this 2 is transferred over here. So we are going to have i3 is equal to, if 2 is transferred, it will become 15 upon 8 ampere. So this is the value of i3. Okay. Space was not there, that's why it has been done like this. Okay. First of all, this is the solution, then this is the solution, then a bit this. So value of i3 we have calculated, value of i2 we have calculated, value of i1 we have calculated, but still it is not our answer. Let us note these values somewhere. So these values are, I1 is equal to, we have calculated here it is 5.2 ampere. I2 we have calculated it is 5.8 ampere. And I3 we have calculated it is 15 upon 8 ampere. So these are the values. Okay. We have calculated. Now this is not our final answer. Okay. This is not our final answer. We are supposed to tell the currents in the circuit. Current in the branches. Okay. So let us see what are the values of current flowing in the branches. Okay. The values we have got. I1 is equal to 5 by 2 ampere. I2 is equal to 5 by 8 ampere. And I3 is equal to 15 upon 8 ampere. Okay. Now we are supposed to tell what are the currents. So let us see. Current in IAB branch. We have assumed it to be I2. And value of I2 we have calculated. It is 5.8 ampere. Now current in this branch CA. ICA. We have assumed to be at I1 and I1 is 5.2 ampere. 5.2 ampere. Now in this branch, AD. IAD. Current is flowing from A to D. So I have written AD. I1 minus I2. I1 minus I2. So it is 5 upon 2. Minus 5.8. If we take the LCM, 2 and 8, it will be 8. 2 4s are 5, 4s are 20. 20 minus 5, it will become how much? 15 upon 8 ampere. So this is the value of IAD. IAD. 15 upon 8 ampere. Okay? Now, next, IBC. IBC. Current is I2 plus I3. So what is I2 plus I3? The value of I2 is 5.8. The value of I3 is 15 upon 8. When we add them, it will become 20 upon 8. Or we can write 5.2 ampere. Okay? For 20 upon 8, it is 5.2 ampere. Now the current in CD branch. ICD. It is I2 plus I3 minus I1. I2 plus I3 minus I1. So we have solved I2 plus I3 over here. It is 5 by 2. I1 is already 5 by 2, it will become 0 ampere. Means there will be no current in the CD branch. Okay, there will be no current in the CD branch. Now, the branch DEB, we have assumed to be I3. The value of I3 is 15 upon 8 ampere. Now, this question is completed. This question is of 5 marks only. This question is of 5 marks. Right? So alone one question is of 5 marks and that's why it is too lengthy. Okay? So this is all for the day. I hope you are solving your numericals from Kirchhoff's law. And we have done also so many numericals. Two numericals I have told you. Rest of the numerical just try. Okay? In NCERT some of the questions are given. So just go through one question is there in unsolved. Okay? So just go through that question. Try to solve it. If you are not able to solve, let me know. We will discuss that. Okay, so this is all for today. Thank you.